Tucked away behind Dixon's apple orchard, Pines Canyon was home to about 30 property owners before the Las Conchas fire. What's lost now is more than just burned down cabins. The land is literally washing away. First Alert meteorologist Eric Green tells us what's next for these wildfire victims.
The first time I saw it, it was really a magical place. I knew right away that this was a very special place.
Lined with beautiful gorges, tent rock formations, and a creek running through it, Pines Canyon was a popular site for camping and a vacation and retirement home for a lucky few who owned land back there. But the Las Conchas fire and then several rounds of flash flooding have taken it all away.
For me, leaving it to the next generation became more important. It's not our retirement anymore, it's our legacy.
But keeping this private land on a national forest is becoming increasingly difficult. The only access they had to it was a road along a creek bed, which is now completely washed away.
I am very prepared to go back, get my hammer out, and do it again. We're there. We're ready. But we can't.
Mark is still paying taxes on his property, what's left of it anyway, knowing that if he stopped, he would lose it to the state in foreclosure. Estimates to rebuild a road back up through the base of the canyon are as high as $750,000 per mile, and the road used to be 9 miles long, meaning it could cost around $6 million. The Forest Service hasn't told these people what will happen, so they are left to wait and pay their property taxes. I'm First Alert meteorologist Eric Green, KOAT Action 7 News.
Pines Canyon was also a popular camping destination, but now all of the campsites are gone.